Number 5. Liberal Arts is a 2012 American comedy film directed by Josh Radner. The story revolves around Jesse Fisher, played by Josh Radner, a middle-aged university administrator. He is invited to attend the retirement party of a professor at his alma mater, where he encounters a charming young woman named Zibby, played by Elizabeth Olsen. Jesse and Zibby embark on a journey through Manhattan, discovering connections and exploring the complexities of their lives. The film takes a lighthearted and humorous approach to themes such as adulthood, love, and the meaning of life. It reflects on the romantic and enchanting aspects of college life while addressing deeper questions.
Jesse, this is my daughter Zibby.
Hey.
Hi. She's a sophomore.
What was your major?
I was English with a minor in history, just to make sure I was fully unemployable.
You're like back in college.
You're overdressed.
I don't know if you know this, but I'm a few years older than you.
Did you think this was like a romantic thing? Just kidding.
We connect really well, don't you think?
I just can't figure out if it's because you're advanced or because I'm stunted.
Because I'm advanced.
What the hell are you doing?
I don't know.
Nobody feels like an adult. It's the world's dirty secret.
I never met anyone that I trusted until now.
I'm 35.
It doesn't bother me.
Well, it bothers me.
My advice to you is put some armor around that gooey little heart of yours.
One of the things I love about being here was the feeling that anything was possible. You get out of school and anything could happen. And then you do get out and life happens.
So you're saying I should prepare myself for suckiness?
No. A liberal arts education solves all your problems.
Number 4. Kodachrome is a 2017 American drama film directed by Mark Rosso. The story revolves around Matt Ryder, played by Jason Sudeikis, who receives a unique assignment. With the Kodachrome color film factory on the verge of closing down, Matt's estranged father, played by Ed Harris, requests him to personally deliver the last roll of Kodachrome film to the factory. Ben is a renowned photographer battling cancer, and he wishes to capture some special photos with this last roll of film. However, given the long-standing conflicts and estrangement between Matt and his father, the mission becomes an attempt to repair their strained relationship. During the journey, Matt invites Ben's nurse, Zoe, played by Elizabeth Olsen, to accompany them. Together, they embark on a cross-country road trip in the United States, encountering various adventures and unforeseen events along the way. The film explores their emotional journey as they rediscover and understand the complex dynamics of their relationships.
Need that thing for a second.
What the hell are you doing?
We're strictly analog here. Turn that up, will you, Zoe? Love this song.
You made the effort to come, so you may as well try and get to know him a little bit.
Watch your fingers.
I wouldn't mind seeing my brother one more time.
Matt, what?
Why'd you come on this trip?
This was the last chance to see how you measured up against the colossal bastard I've hated all these years.
How am I doing?
You're holding your own.
He came on this trip for you, and you have done nothing to earn his love.
I don't know what happened to me, but we're broke inside of me. But those nights with you, if I could choose one time in my life to live in forever, that would be it. We're also frightened of time, how it moves on, things disappear. But that's why we're photographers. We're preservationists by nature. We take pictures to stop time, to commit moments to eternity. Human nature made tangible.
Number 3. Marcy May Marlene is a 2011 psychological thriller film directed by Sean Durkin. The movie revolves around a young woman named Martha, played by Elizabeth Olsen. the story follows Martha as she escapes from a cult and attempts to reintegrate into normal society. However, the psychological trauma she endured within the cult and her deep-seated mistrust of reality lead her into a state of confusion, making it challenging to distinguish between her past and present. The film employs a non-linear narrative structure, presenting Martha's experiences through flashbacks and her current struggles to find stability. It delves into the absurdities and uncertainties she faced within the cult while simultaneously depicting her attempts to establish a sense of security in her new family.
About 3 hours, why?
Do you ever have that feeling where you can't tell if something's a memory or if it's something you dreamed?
I don't blame you for not trusting people. If you're ever going to have a meaningful relationship, you need to let your guard down. We want to help you. Let us in.
What happened to you?
You're a teacher and a leader, Marcy. Now prove it. Shoot it.
They're living animals.
So shoot Max then. Go ahead.
I know who I am. I am a teacher and a leader. You just never let me be that.
I don't think she should stay with us anymore. We can't ignore the fact that her behavior is insane.
I'm her only family.
We have to leave. We all have to leave.
What happened?
I don't know!
Well, she's just a picture. Lives on my wall. Just a picture.
You're my favorite. I won't lose you.
That's all.
Number 2. Wind River is a 2017 crime thriller film directed by Taylor Sheridan. The story unfolds on a Native American reservation in Wyoming, where a young Native American woman is found dead in the wilderness. The FBI sends a young female agent, Jane Banner, played by Elizabeth Olsen, to investigate the case. A local hunter and tracker, Corey Lambert, portrayed by Jeremy Renner, assists in the investigation. As the inquiry progresses, they uncover dark secrets and heinous crimes within the Native American community. Battling extreme weather conditions and challenging terrain, they must work together to track suspects, unveil the truth, and seek justice for the victim.
They have 6 officers to cover an area the size of Rhode Island. Maybe you can help.
Well, I know what the tracks say.
What is it that you do again?
I hunt predators.
So why don't you come hunt one for me then? Why would a teenage girl be out here? What is she running from?
You're looking for clues, but you're missing all the signs.
Shouldn't we wait for backup?
This isn't the land of backup, Jane. This is a land of you're on your own.
Oh my God. You won't get the answers you're looking for, no matter what you find. Why would your daughter run from home?
I don't know why. She didn't tell me.
Out here,
you cannot blink. Not ever.
This place, what it takes from us, what it took from you.
I got lucky.
Luck lives in the city.
Get your hand up that weapon!
Number 1. Avengers: Endgame is a 2019 superhero film directed by Anthony and Joe Russo. It is a part of the Marvel Cinematic Universe and serves as the 4th Avengers film. Set in the aftermath of Avengers: Infinity War, the movie depicts the surviving Avengers and their allies uniting to reverse the catastrophic events caused by the destruction of half of all life in the universe. The storyline explores their desperate attempt to restore balance and confronts the challenges arising from the aftermath of the battle against the formidable Thanos. Elizabeth Olsen portrays Scarlet Witch, also known as Wanda Maximoff, in the film. Scarlet Witch is a superhero with potent abilities, including reality manipulation. Throughout Endgame, she becomes a pivotal character, contributing significantly to the battle against a powerful adversary while grappling with personal struggles and grief.
I saw all these people die.
I keep telling everybody they should move on. Some do, but not us.
Even if there's a small chance, we owe this to everyone who's not in this room to try.
We will. Whatever it takes. Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes.
I like this one.